There we go. We're recording. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Epic Empire Team Call, home of Epic Empire. The car. I'm super excited. This team is exploding. Like, we are adding coaches, like, daily. Five, four. I mean, I see it in the back office. Even though they don't show up necessarily in the team, we have hybrid teams that don't always add to Epic Empire. So we are growing like crazy. And we have, I think, one or two new diamonds tomorrow. So that's super, super exciting. I think we've had like, what, four diamonds in the past 2 weeks? Crazy. All right. Super Saturday is April 2nd. If you're in DC, Maryland, Virginia, then we have Tony Horton and Jeff Hill coming and Tara Carr as our guest speaker. It's going to be amazing. I can say if you are coming, please make sure you get there early and you carpool. If you're staying at the hotel, you're golden. But parking is going to be a madhouse. I'm so glad that my face is not going to be there as in charge. No, anyways, I help run the DC council, but I'm not going to be there. I'll be in Nashville for kind of a once-in-a-lifetime thing. So I'm sad because Afton's flying from Myrtle Beach. Ren's flying from Alabama. I mean, there's going to be a whole group of Epic Empire coaches there. So I'm sending Josh there, not as a babysitter. Yeah, Kelly made fun of me, so I was sending him as a babysitter. But just so you guys can find each other, because I know a lot of you have never actually even met face-to-face, but we've all become really good friends. So I want to make sure you don't miss each other, and you all sit together. Try really hard to sit together and get a big group picture, please, 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 please. It's good for your business. Just show that you're a part of this amazing team. So Super Saturday, April 2nd. If you're not in the DC region, there are Super Saturdays all over the country, Canada, Puerto Rico. There's no reason why you shouldn't be there unless, like, it's your wedding day. Just kidding. Or you're having a baby. Those are your excuses. But anyways, make sure you get to a Super Saturday. So I want to go over recognition. So I'm going to stop my video, but you guys can still hear me so that I can go into Epic Empire. And normally I would just skip over this, but I can't because our numbers are doing amazing. So let me jump into our team page. Hopefully you can still hear. Oh, look, there's another new coach right now, signed by Kelly. Hopefully new coach Megan is on the call. All right. Pulling up the Success Club document in Epic Empire, and that is how I track these numbers. So if you don't hear your name, it's because you didn't add your number. So make sure you go in there. Remember, you're your own CEO, and you report your own numbers in the team page. All right, so Lisa Stranahan, I think I'm saying that right. One coach and two points. Lisa Crichton, one coach and 1 point. Sherry at 2 points. Kathy Cho at 2 points. Jason Delancey, 2 points. Debbie Delaney at 2 points. Jody Allred at 2 points. Jennifer Combs, one coach, 2 points. Julie Robertson, one coach, 2 points. Matt Rio, two coaches and 2 points. Gina Campbell at 4 points. Effie Huddleston at 4 points. Jody, I'm not sure if I'm saying this right, Blount, boom, 4 points. Kristen, oh, here's another, Cling and Peel, am I saying that right? One coach and 4 points. Tara Conway, one coach and 4 points. Denise Hebert, three coaches and 4 points. Lisa Harris, two coaches and 4 points. Amy O'Rear, two coaches and 4 points. Okay, you guys are on the board, and you totally have time to get into Success Club. The minimum is 5, so you have plenty of time to get to 5 points. Most of you guys are at, like, 4, so there's no reason not to get one more point. All right, the people who are in Success Club are Christy Simmons at 1 coach and 5 points. Congratulations, Christy. You're kind of a new coach, and you are doing it, and I'm proud of you. Kelly Slaughter at 6 points. Erin McMillan at 1 coach and 6 points. Katherine Jeffries at 2 coaches and 6 points. Kathy Park, 2 coaches and 6 points. Karen Hong, 2 coaches and 6 points. First month as a coach, and she's going Emerald and hit Success Club. Great job. Holly Garvey at 1 coach and 7 points. Sarah Grimm, 1 coach and 7 points. Tammy at 4. I need to figure out how to pronounce your last name. Tammy F. 8 points. Tracy Cameron, good to see you on the board again, Tracy. 8 points. Dina Bauer at 8 points. Kelly King at 9 points. Carla Perry at 1 coach and 9 points. All right. So those of you who are in Success Club 5, congratulations. But then we got the overachievers, those Success Club 10 peeps. And they are Ren Young at 4 coaches and 10 points. Rebecca Thompson, 3 coaches and 10 points. Sherry Mirador, I think that's a new one, 10 points. I gotta message this Sherry girl because she's new. I've not recognized her name before. Katie Burke, 2 coaches and 10 points. Afton Rio, 6 coaches and 10 points. Girl, you are on fire. Tatiana Jackson, 2 coaches and 11 points. And Sarah is leading Epic Empire. Sarah McHaffa, new name that I'm not familiar with, 3 coaches and 17 points. Y'all are kicking booty this month, and I'm super duper proud of you. Keep it up. Let's get everybody in Success Club and everybody to at least Emerald. All right. So I am super pumped to introduce to you our guest speaker tonight is Rachel. I'm not going to attempt her last name because I'm not sure how to say it. How do you say it?
Ingham.
All right. Mm-hmm. Coach Rachel. Just kidding. Yep. All right. So Rachel, I met her on our leadership wall for Beachbody. She is a 5-star diamond coach. She's Success Club 10 all-star legend, meaning, listen to this, she's been in Success Club 10 for 24 consecutive months. I can't even say that. I'm a Success Club 5 legend because there's just some months I only got 6 points. But she has been in Success Club 10 for 24 consecutive months. She is also a Beachbody Challenge winner. She is in the 21-day fix infomercial and added to the list, 5-star diamond, and is a 6-figure earner with Beachbody. So I am super, super pumped to hear what you have to say, the wisdom and knowledge. Please tell us all you have because we are taking notes and we are learning. So I'm going to give you the floor, Rachel, and I'm excited to listen.
Well, thank you for having me on. You guys are seriously so blessed to have Jatana as your coach. I know she spoke on our team call on Monday and everyone just like went nuts. And so they're all planning to have their free challenge group sneak peeks and they're super duper excited. I'm going to make this full screen, and Jatana, if anyone's like asking questions in the chat, just make sure you notify me because I can never see them when it's full screen. Is that right? That's close to my right. Technology is not always my friend. But so my name is Rachel Ingham, and I'll just tell you a little bit about me and my story. So I'm from the Chicagoland area, and I've always been a volleyball player, been athletic. I got a full ride to play at the University of Illinois. I got injured and ended up moving to Africa, which is kind of where my heart has been since I was 20 or 19. That's where I met my husband. And so my name is Senegalese, that's West Africa, so Ingham. And I found out that I got accepted to get my master's in social work. We moved to St. Louis so I could get my master's. And I always knew I wanted to help people. I wasn't really sure what that was going to look like. And after I got my master's, we decided to move to Florida, kind of random, but my husband trains horses for a living and he could start his own equestrian business. I could find some kind of social work job and we would be living the dream in Florida. When we moved there, we got, you know, into a pretty big mortgage. His business was just starting, so obviously wasn't going to be profitable. And I couldn't find a job, even with my master's from the number one school in the entire country and all of my experience traveling abroad and everything. So it was kind of like, oh, crap, what are we going to do? We ended up on food stamps, and we really struggled for a while. And I'd actually been a coach for 2 years at that point. I'd been to Summit, and I just had a hobby coach. And so it was like at that moment, I found out I was pregnant. We were on food stamps. And I was like, dude, I know people are having success with this business. What are they doing? I'm just going to figure it out. And so I decided to go all in. And that was about 3 years ago. And so I gained 65 pounds with my pregnancy. I lost it all, won $500 in the Beachbody Challenge. I'm in the 21-day fix infomercial, which is kind of crazy, but I've also become a 5-star diamond, and last year was my first 6-figure year, which is insane. And, you know, it's really not, you know, like 6 figures, that's crazy, but it's more like the freedom that we have now. So I'm able to go back to Senegal and visit the orphanage that I'm working with right now. We're actually moving to France in like a month or so once we get our visas figured out. So my hubby can get, he has an awesome internship opportunity. So we have the freedom to go and do that. And we're not like tied down here. It's just, it's been seriously amazing. And the thing that always, you know, helped me to build my business was I saw other people doing it. And I said, if they can do it, I can too. And so just know when you see like people that are earning a full-time income or 6-figure income in this business, there's nothing special about them. And that if they can do it, you can too. And so I want to talk to you about recruiting, because that's where I made my main focus. And I've recruited probably well over 200 coaches onto my team in the past 3 years. And so that's kind of my main thing that I want to talk to you about. And so the biggest thing with recruiting is to know who you are, your vision, your values, your goals, and think of 3 to 5 things that make you unique. And so these are the things that you're going to be posting about on social media, and these are the things that are going to attract like-minded people to you. And so are you a mom? Are you into mountain biking? Are you a teacher? Are you a chef? Are you big into your faith? Anything that makes you unique and makes you you, because you're not just a Beachbody coach. You know, there are like 400,000 Beachbody coaches out there. You have to know what sets you apart. And it's just all the little things that make you you. So I really don't want you to think of yourself as just a Beachbody coach. Don't identify yourself as that. You are branding you. And so it's really, really important. And so develop your own style. And so in the beginning, when I was struggling for 2 years, what I was doing, I was looking at the top coaches and I was basically copying and pasting what they were doing. And I wasn't being me at all. And so don't try to be Lindsay Matway and copy her posts. The biggest thing is to be authentically you, 100%. You have a voice and people are going to connect with you because of who you are. And if you're trying to copy and paste and emulate the top coaches, people will see right through that. That's where I really struggled. And so make a wish list. Who do you want to do business with? And so we're going to get into an avatar activity in a second, but identify, you know, be specific here, identify the geographic range and start brainstorming a little bit of who you want your target audience to be. Because if you try to be a coach to everybody, you're going to be a coach to nobody. You got to be really, really specific. And so for me, it was, I wanted to work with new moms. And I'll talk about my Lose the Baby Weight group that I did, almost 3 years ago. Holy crap, time goes by really fast. But so you can't do business with everybody. You've got to be specific. And so targeting women isn't enough. You know, in the beginning, I was targeting everybody. Targeting female moms of young children who are strong in their faith, that is a good avatar. And so I want you to start thinking about your avatar right now. Start taking notes if you're not already. You can't really grow a successful business if you don't know who you're trying to target. And so I'm going to start doing a little comparison here. So your avatar is not anyone who loves fitness or anyone who wants to lose weight. That is way too general. And so right now, I actually want you to go through this exercise. I don't know if we'll get through all of this because it's kind of a lot. This took me a good half an hour to go through, but I can definitely get these slides to Jatana. But I want you to think of, like, super specifically, your ideal client, who they are, their name, how old they are, even their hair color, their eye color, marital status, where they live, how much they earn. And a big tip about this, your avatar is probably you before you met Beachbody, before you became a coach. And so start thinking about blogs that your avatar follows. What is she Googling? The goal is to really get into her head. So when you're crafting posts about your challenge group, or about the coaching opportunity, you are speaking directly to that person. So think about where her fantasy vacation is. What's her favorite YouTube video? Conferences or events that she attends? Who does she idolize? What books is she reading? Start thinking about all these things. Start writing them down and taking notes. And I'll definitely make sure to get this to Jatana. Okay. So I want you to take a second and step into your avatar's shoes and really look at life through that person's eyes. And so right before she decides to either become a coach on your team or to join your challenge group, what is the emotion that she's feeling at that exact same moment? Is she feeling, or he, feeling fed up that she can't fit into any of the clothes that are in her closet? Is she looking in the mirror and just wishing that she had her pre-baby body back? Or is she wishing that she could be outside running around outside with her kids, but she just doesn't have the energy to do it? What is she saying to herself in her head? Is she saying, I'll never get back into shape because I just don't have the time?
In the kitchen?
What specific words or phrases is she using? And what story is she telling herself? Maybe, you know, for my avatar, it was, I'll never be able to get my pre-baby body back. And so to let her know that it is possible, I can help you get into your pre-baby jeans. And so write down everything that comes to mind, kind of like a journal entry that your customer is writing. So write it from their perspective. And especially be really embarrassing and like non-PC stuff that no one would ever say out loud. So it might be like, oh my God, I have to freaking lay down on the bed to try and squeeze these jeans over my, like, my booty that's grown so big from having these kids. So don't try and be like all proper or whatever. Like, if your avatar curses, then you can curse. If she's using slang, use slang. But what is it that she's saying before she decides to join your challenge? So write your answers like you are that person. And so, what a good start to your avatar sounds like. My avatar is a female, 25 to 35 years of age, works a full-time 9-to-5 job, has a family of 2 kids, finds themselves frustrated, feeling alone every day because they don't know how they're going to make ends meet. What is really good is my avatar is 32. Her name is Melissa. She's a writer. She's been wanting to start a blog for months now, but she doesn't know where to start. She's a good writer, but she could really use some help on how to structure and format a blog. Plus, she's really not sure what she wants to write about most of the time. So the more specific you can be with this, the better. And so another activity for you to do right now is to write down 10 characteristics of your ideal coach. And so do you want to work with someone that has a sense of humor? Are they creative, focused, driven, motivated, assertive? You have to think about who exactly you want to work with. And then if you yourself are not these characteristics, then that's really what you need to be working on in your personal development. So if you want a coach on your team to be consistent, but you're not consistent in your own business, that's something you really got to work on, because your team is going to duplicate every single thing that you do, whether it's good or whether it's bad. So what number are you in each of these areas from a scale of 1 to 10? And then work on that area. So I want to show you just a couple examples of top coaches that are really good at pitching to their niche. Tara Carr is awesome at this. And so if you don't know Tara Carr, she is in the Millionaires Club, a superstar diamond coach. And so her husband was deployed in Afghanistan. And her whole thing, her challenge group, she was targeting military wives whose husbands were deployed. Talk about a freaking specific niche. How cool is that? And so her challenge was get fit for the homecoming. And obviously, she was really successful at doing that. Another one, Melanie Mitro, she targets busy moms. And so one of her things is she does busy moms build a business. And she just shows, yeah, I'm a busy mom too, but if I can get this done with my little kids chasing at my feet, then you can too. And I wanted to show you, so it's really important when you're, so obviously with recruiting, you're going to be reaching out via private message and inviting people, and I'll talk about that in a second. But it's really important that you're posting your life on social media and start attracting people to you. So we call that attraction marketing, and I talk to my team about this, and I call it breadcrumbing posts. And so you're kind of like, throughout your day, throughout your week, you're breadcrumbing posts about coaching. And so obviously not every single post is going to be a breadcrumbing post about coaching. You want to make sure you're adding value and sharing, you know, the 3 to 5 things that make you unique. And so tonight I shared that I was drinking wine because wine is like one of my things. But I also shared that I was getting on this call. I forget which post it was, but I'll find it. And so breadcrumbing posts, if you're posting 3 to 5 times a day, one of these, maybe a day, or like five a week could be a breadcrumbing post. And so I'm just sharing the little things that I love about coaching. And it does not have to be income related at all. You don't have to be a six-figure earner or anything to do this. You could start doing these breadcrumbing posts today. Think about the things that you love about coaching. And so I'm just going to show a bunch of different examples so you can get an idea of what these breadcrumbing posts are like. And so I just did a spotty with my mom. I'm blessed to have the flexibility with my job as a beach ready coach that I can do this stuff all the time. And I ask a question. This one, working hard or hardly working. I'm just sharing that my parents are in town and I thank God for my beach body business and the flexibility that we have as a coach. So I'm not sharing income, I'm sharing more the lifestyle. Another one, just counting your blessings. I was really sick that day, and I was just grateful that with Beachbody, I didn't have to worry about requesting time off of work, and I could lay in bed and get better. This post, this was a longer post where I'm actually telling my story about how we were broke, couldn't afford our mortgage, had to sell our truck, and all these things. And I just shared a picture of me paying extra on our mortgage principal, because for me, that was huge considering we had to sell our truck to pay our mortgage before. And so I'm sharing that story. And obviously, anytime you're sharing an income post or anything you're buying with Beachbody or free trips that you're earning, make sure you include the earning disclaimer at the bottom of the post. Jatana can share that with you. You can't see it here because I only took a picture of part of it. And I'll share a couple more. So this is another one. And it's a really long post, but basically it's just more telling my story. And so not every time you do a breadcrumbing post are you going to be telling your entire story or anything like that, but I'm just sharing where we were and where we are now and what we're able to do. And so the things that I share that we've been able to do: pay extra on our mortgage, fully funded emergency account, being able to sponsor 5 babies in Africa and make a real impact. And then I say the only way you can earn money in this business is by helping others and changing lives. And so I'm not trying to attract anyone that's like in this for a quick buck. I would love to attract people that want to sponsor babies in Africa and who are in the mission trips and doing that kind of thing. And so that's what I'm sharing that I'm able to do with the income. Not that I'm like out buying some fancy car or anything. If that's what you're into, then totally post about that. But post about what you love you've been able to do with, and your income, like this could be super small. Like, have you been able to pay off your gas money with Beachbody? Start off like the small things that you're able to do. This one, not an income post at all. I'm just sharing working with my team. And so you could take a picture of yourself right now and just share, I love that my business has opportunities for me to grow and learn so I can do X, Y, and Z, whatever it is that you want to accomplish. And so that would be considered a breadcrumbing post, that the learning opportunities that you have as a coach, so people know that they're not just like thrown out there and have to figure it out on their own. So I shared, I used to be shy, for real, I did. And like too shy to even post a status update on Facebook. And crazy how much becoming a coach and the personal growth has improved my confidence. Let's see. Okay, a big thing with these breadcrumbing posts is to share your why and to share your vision for the future. So let's say you're not successful as a coach right now, which is fine. I wasn't either. And I'm just saying, I'm taking a picture of me. You can see my computer there that I'm working. I'm saying that I'm working now, so in the future we'll be financially free. We won't have a debt. We won't have a mortgage. I work hard now so we can give and we can make an impact. Who am I going to attract when I say that kind of thing? I'm working hard now so we can improve the lives of babies in Senegal. Without, you know, the freedom that coaching could give us, it'd be impossible to get over to Senegal and West Africa and do the kind of mission work that we want to do. I work hard now so we can have a fully funded emergency or college account for TJ. So I'm attracting moms who want to pay for their kids' college. I work hard now so we can have the freedom to do whatever the heck we want to do. And then I don't want to attract people that think this is something easy. And so I post down there, it may mean sacrificing time spent in front of the TV or another time suck, but I wouldn't have it any other way. My family, and then I continue, like, my family's like first, and it's worth the sacrifices to make this happen. And so I want to attract people that know that this is a legit business and know that it's hard work. And so that's why I post that. I don't want to attract just anybody that thinks they can come in and make money. And I share a lot about my why. And so my heart is full. A coach on my team made a video sharing how much her confidence has grown since she joined our team. She was able to pay with her groceries or weekly paycheck. And then I say, this is why I do what I do. Helping my coaches see that there's more for them out there. Another one that I just did, and actually I did this tonight, mentoring coaches on my team, helping them set some big goals. And then I share what their vision is. Anne wants to retire her hubby, stop living paycheck to paycheck. Sarah wants to have the freedom to travel. Can't wait to see these ladies achieve their goals and more. And I already had a comment. What is this? I want to gain financial independence for myself. Okay, so that's a lot of breadcrumbing posts, but I wanted to give you guys just a bunch of different ideas that you could do for the posts. And with this one, when I said this is why I do what I do, if you haven't read the book Start With Why by Simon Sinek, I highly recommend it. People don't really care what you do. They don't really care what you do as a coach. They care why you do it. Why are you as a coach? So share that why and share that vision often. And so homework for you guys is to post 3 to 5 breadcrumbing posts this week. And tag your coach in it and share it in your team page if you want to. And so in the beginning, when you're doing this like attraction marketing thing, you're not going to be sponsoring, 100 coaches or whatever from it. But what will happen, you'll probably have people that like it. And so what I would do is follow up with every single person that either likes or comments on your post. And then here's just a sample script that you can use. Hey, I saw you liked my post about whatever it was about coaching. I don't know if you'd be interested or just supporting, which is much appreciated, but I actually think you'd be an awesome fit for my team. Do you want me to send some info on what it is that I do as a coach? And so this works so well because a lot of people will like your post, but they won't comment on it and they won't message you about coaching. But if you reach out to them, there's a really good chance that they'll say, yeah, I've actually been thinking about it, but I've been too afraid to approach you. Or yeah, I've been thinking about it, but I just didn't have the courage or whatever. I didn't have the time to reach out to you. And then we have follow-up steps for this post, Jatana, if you want it. The script, I'm more than happy to give it to you. But so with that, with all those people that are liking on your post, which you might only have one or two in the beginning, but as you're consistently doing this stuff and as you're growing, it'll grow to more. You might have 10 people liking your post and then 50, and then it just gets crazy. And so it's important that you're adding to your network at least 3 to 5 new people every day, either using Instagram, Twitter. I use Instagram and Facebook. I hate Twitter. To connect, ask them to find you on Facebook. Join groups with your niche. And so one of the best things that I ever did was I joined a mommy group when I was pregnant with my son. And so that mommy group has made me probably like $80,000, which is insane. But I went into that group not with like the idea that I'm going to recruit anybody or get anyone to join my challenge group. I wasn't posting about Beachbody in that group at all. I was connecting with the ladies that were in there. And we were just sharing experiences. And then I would reach out to them in private message and I would just get to know them. And they would start following my posts and see what I was doing with coaching and say, Rachel, I want to do this. Or I reached out to them and say, hey, this would really benefit you. Have you ever considered becoming a coach? So make new friends, ask questions about their interests and hobbies. And the goal is to always figure out their sign. Write this down. You want to figure out their sign, their strengths, their interests, their goals, and their needs. And so when you figure this out, it's really easy to ask them if they've ever considered becoming a coach. And so I'm not just going to ask anybody to join my team as a coach. I want to make sure I know how coaching will benefit them. And so if I'm talking to Angie in my mommy group and she says, yeah, my due date's coming up really soon. I don't want to go back to work, but we really can't afford for me to stay home. Hello. I could just ask her, have you ever considered becoming a coach? That's like the magic question. Write that down. And I'm asking because I think you'd be really great at it with how energetic and positive you are. And I think it would really benefit you because you'd be able to earn some extra money at home, being able to stay home with your baby so you don't have to go back to work. Easy, easy peasy. And then this is, sometimes I send cold coach invite scripts. And so this one is for people that I think would legitimately be a really good fit for my team. I know this is kind of out of the blue. You keep popping into my head. I think you'd be great at this because X, Y, and Z. I honestly have to have you on my team. And would you want more details on what this would look like for you? So this is something that I send to people who I, like, honestly, I do think they'd be a really good fit for my team. And most of the, if they say no, they say no. You're going to get no's, and that's totally fine. But a lot of times they say yes. You know, I would love to take a look, and that's when you can add them to your sneak peek group or whatever it is that you do in your team as a system. So invite to backstage pass sneak peek. Always use a third-party tool. So I never myself actually explain coaching to people. If they ask me about it or they say they want more info, I always invite them to a sneak peek and we share videos in there. And then follow up. The fortune really is in the follow-up. I've had to follow some people seriously like 20 times. Oh my God, they drove me crazy. But they did end up joining my team because I kept following up with them. So make sure, don't cross them off their list until they say like, hey, I never want to talk to you again. Stop asking me about this. And so getting to know them also is really important. So why would you want to do this? What does it mean to you? Can you tell me more about that? And so when I'm talking to somebody about coaching, if they ask me about it, these are just some of the questions that I ask. Or after a sneak peek group, these are the questions that I would ask. And so I'm not the one actually explaining coaching. Like I said, I'm asking questions to get to know them to see why coaching would be a good fit for them. So I'm kind of like the interviewer here. And so I say, can you tell me more about that? Asking them to elaborate on it. And so once they tell you why, ask them what it will feel like. And so when they say, I want to be able to stay home with my baby. Okay, what will it feel like when you're able to stay home with your baby? And then when they tell you that, when you can anchor it to an emotion, you got them. So Tony Robbins says that emotions are the silent force that runs the world, which is so true. And handling objections, because if you're inviting, you're going to get a lot of them. Feel, felt, found. And so I've had a lot of people tell me, you know, I'm not in good enough shape to be a coach. Okay, I totally know how you feel. I actually felt the same way, especially when I was 250 pounds. But I found that when you're on your weight loss journey, people actually relate to you a lot more, and you'll be able to help a lot more people. And last slide, remember, like I said, you're going to get no's. A no is just I'm not right now. Make sure you're following up. Yes is the destination. No is how you get there. And that's all I have, girl.
You mean that's all you have? That was loaded, packed, full of information. And people were asking in the chat if you could share your slides and your scripts. And I know I still owe you my challenge group point tracker and my posts, but Nicole, I'll send all that stuff to you. Thank you so much. I wish I had pen and paper to take notes, but at least we have this recorded so I can go back and listen. I love how organized you are. Your team is very blessed. So I want to open up if anybody had any questions. Anything that, I mean, I know you guys are going to get the recording and you're going to get the slides and scripts and stuff, but sometimes it's easier once I can clarify what exactly she does. So somebody said they like the SIGN acronym.
I have a question in regards to, what do you mean by third party when you're doing a sneak peek?
Third party tool is basically anything that's not you. And so a sneak peek would be a third party tool. So instead of you explaining Beachbody, you just invite them to a sneak peek or send them a webinar or a recorded video or something like that. So that is just a third party tool. It's just something that's not you. Sorry, that's like advanced lingo.
Also, real quick before we start losing people, because we always do at this time, will you guys do a quick picture and nobody gets mad because they're not looking at the camera or smiling or picking the nose or something? So I'm on my phone, so I can't physically take a picture, but if somebody can post it in Epic, that'd be great. All right, everybody smile. Somebody take it. Who's taking it? Somebody taking it? Nicola? I'm smiling. Go ahead. I can smile all day. One, two, three. All right, we got it. We're good.
What is that?
Oh, that was a cute little voice, whoever that was. All right, question.
Hi.
Anybody else have a question?
So do you only invite to the people that are on these lists? Like, do you never invite people that aren't, I mean, because I'm new, so I'm just like all over the place, and I'm inviting everybody on all different levels. So, I mean, I'm just curious about your suggestion for me. Or new people. I mean, I'm just trying
to learn
right now.
Yeah. So invite. I would invite whoever you know who's on your list.
Okay.
Do you have a strategy for new coaches on invite? Like how they, because sometimes it can be overwhelming. You're like, I don't even know where to start because they're starting from scratch. So do you have a message for coaches?
Well, the first thing to help them get to Emerald, the first thing, like, think about who in your life would really benefit from Shakeology, because that's number one. Usually people would be interested, especially if you have, like, a physical transformation using Beachbody products, they'd want to learn more about it. And so who in your life would really benefit from being on Shakeology? They either want more energy, they want to lose weight, they want to get healthy. And then think of who would benefit from the coaching opportunity. Who is unsatisfied in their job? Who wants to make more money? Who wants to travel? Who wants to have freedom? Who wants to become a stay-at-home mom? It's like 95% of the population needs us in some way. And so think about who those people are and invite them. So we have scripts for our team that we use to send out, basically inviting them to a sneak peek and to learn more. But the biggest thing is just invite. I know Tommy Migrant said something when I was like a new coach that always stuck with me. He said, don't you dare hold someone else's future back in your mouth because you're too afraid to invite them. And ever since I heard that, I was like, I don't care if they tell me no. I know that I have something that can completely transform their life. And if they say no, that's fine. If they say yes, then sweet. Let's change lives.
Absolutely. And I can second that because I think about my situation. My life is obviously completely different from coaching. I'm about to pass my husband's income, which he's very excited about. But to think that the coach that brought me on board, who's like not full out doing it the way I am, which is totally okay, but if she would have not been confident enough to at least mention it to me, like most of you guys might not even be here. Isn't that weird? Like, think about the ripple effect. While my coaches might not be here, but it keeps going on and on and on. There's people's incomes that wouldn't be here because of this. So never think, like, I don't know, when I talk about coaching, I talk about it so confidently because I'm so passionate about it because it's changed my life personally. But don't put a label on somebody that, well, they probably wouldn't want to do it. Because how do you know? They might want to, and it might change their life. And if that person had never invited me and explained coaching to me, I wouldn't be where I am right now. My family wouldn't have the financial freedom that it has right now. And most of the people on this call wouldn't be here. So it's, yeah, I totally agree. And I love Tommy's quote. I've heard that one before. Amazing. Mm-hmm. Sorry. Other coaches or questions? I'm sitting on a heated seat. I'm sweating.
So I was curious about, are you inviting people also, like I have somebody in mind that's not necessarily, she's not using Beachbody, but she's had this amazing transformation and I like totally can foresee, like see her being an awesome coach. So how do you approach like those types of situations?
So the biggest thing that I would do is to figure out her sign. So you know her strengths, you know she's interested in like transformation, health and fitness. So what are her goals and her needs? And so I found out really quickly that I cannot project my goals and needs on someone else. I've known a lot of people that I thought they would be awesome coaches. And I like vomited, you should be a coach way before I figured out their goals and needs. And I totally lost them. I remember I got like a customer lead from Beachbody and he was in the military. And I'm like, oh my gosh, you can sign up for free and be a coach. And he was like, I don't care. Because I didn't figure out what was important to him and why coaching would benefit him. So see if she needs extra money, if she wants to be able to travel, if she wants free time, all these things that coaching can offer. You know, just ask more questions to get to know her a little bit better. So obviously you see how it would be a good fit for her, which is great, but she wants to know what's in it for me. How will this benefit me?
I loved how you talked on, the breadcrumbing thing, because for the longest time, the first 2 years of my coaching business, I loved the concept of it, but I was only doing it for challengers. I was so confident in my fitness journey, and I was sharing and breadcrumbing my fitness journey and eating clean and things like that. But I wasn't doing the coaching side of it as much. Or I was posting about coaching, but I wasn't breadcrumbing coaching. And I noticed the minute I shifted to that, is when my recruitment went up. And that was the year that I went from Emerald to 5-star. People began to become drawn to the business a little easier. Like it was an easier transition because they had heard me talk about it for so long. And not even just like overtly talking about coaching, but just the things and the benefits that coaching has done for me and my family and my life. So I love that. I hope you guys start doing that. Even just coming off of this cruise, I had, I don't know, 12 people interested in coaching. I could even ask Nicola. I'm like, I'm overwhelmed. There's people, everybody wants to coach all of a sudden because they've been seeing these cruise pictures. So every little thing that's beneficial for you for coaching, you've got to find a spot in your timeline or on your wall to be able to talk about it. If I send you a card congratulating you for Success Club, take a picture of that card and be like, I love that I feel appreciated in my job, something. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Take those moments and put them on your wall. Sorry. What else? Any other questions? It's only 9:40. We're doing good.
Bye, Mr. Tama.
Oh, who is that? Where's that coming from?
Aiden.
I can't see.
Waving to me.
Oh, she's wait. Hi, Hayden.
Say hi. He's been begging to say hi the whole time.
Oh, sweet you. Thing.
Yeah.
Hayden, do you have a question?
Do you have a question, Hayden?
Yeah, I do.
All right, what's your question?
Jake the Pirate. Jake the Pirate.
Jake. Oh, sweet thing. Anybody else have a question? He's so adorable.
Diamond.
I can't understand it.
Sarah go diamond.
Somebody goes diamond. Oh, is Sarah. Sarah going? Is your Aunt Sarah going diamond tomorrow?
Say yes, she is.
That's yay, Sarah. Sarah.
But say Sarah's going diamond.
That's not Sarah.
That's Anna.
Sarah is going diamond. Very exciting. And I have to check in on Julie. I think Julie was right there pacing with her. So I think Julie is going diamond tomorrow. Yay!
Yes.
So exciting. So it's funny because Ren and Julie are on the same leg in Joshua's business center. So Joshua is still a one star, but not that he cares about star diamond or anything. You guys are loving it. I love how you guys are running together. So, oh, let me make sure I say this before I let everybody go and thank our amazing guest speaker. But remember, we have a diamond retreat, right? It's in the Outer Banks. The house is booked. It's gorgeous. It's right on the beach. We are going to have some guest speakers, maybe flying in from corporate, maybe Summer Tucker. I don't know. We're working on a few guest speakers. If you get diamond before a certain date, it's all the details are on the picture. I'm not going to quote anything right here on the recording, but if you get it by a certain date, you get Kelly King. I'm going to kick your butt. I think I'm obsession with Chad Tucker, but anyways, I just said that on a recorded call. If you get it by a certain date, you get free headshots. So that's super exciting. And it's really boosted my business the minute I was able to bump my little selfie into a professional headshot because people take you a little bit more seriously. But make sure you get there because there's only 20 spots and they're filling up. thank you so much, Rachel, for being on this call and for being willing to share what you do with your team. I am going to get you that point tracker. My life's just been a little crazy right now. And what we post in our challenge group for our daily posts. But thank you so much. What a blessing you've been to our team. And
thank
I hope
you for having me.
Absolutely. And this is the wonderful thing about Beachbody. In general, we love to help each other out. This is not about being selfish, but pouring in. Because she knows the more she pours into you guys and into her team, the more lives that are going to be changed because of this. So I hope you guys have gained some confidence tonight to start posting properly. She gave you some homework, 3 to 5 breadcrumbing posts this week, right? And then what I also want you to do is one major aha moment or nugget or whatever, post it in Epic Empire so all those who were on the call want to come watch the recording, okay? So go post in Epic Empire one thing that you learned tonight so that we can all kind of share with that and make those other people jump on the recording. So I love you guys. Have a great night. Thank you so much, Rachel. I have a 2-hour drive home now late at night. So bye.